नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांता स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। Hare Krishna everyone, welcome back yet again to another beautiful video on this very important shloka, shloka 21 of chapter 3 Karma Yoga of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. If you haven't already watched, kindly watch the previous three episodes and then come back to this. So I left you with a question in the last video. Okay, very good, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Srimad Bhagavatam, there are so many other scriptures. Okay, we will study, we will find the characters to emulate and look up to. But now, what if I want somebody who is physically present, who I want to emulate? That is where it is not just the characters in the Shastra, your guru can be somebody who you want to look up to. So find yourself a bona fide spiritual master. Acharya. Acharya means what? One who leads by example. In my own case, I don't find anybody as inspiring in my life as my own spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada. What a life and what a great personality. Such a pure devotee of the Lord. So it's very, very important. Even in Bhagavad Gita, later in fourth chapter, Krishna says that you need to find yourself a spiritual master. But what kind of spiritual master? A bona fide spiritual master. Why a bona fide spiritual master? Because a bona fide spiritual master, an acharya, his life is not different from what is given in the Shastra. There is book Bhagavatam, there is the person Bhagavatam. What is a person Bhagavatam doing? He is simply taking all the instructions from the book Bhagavata, scripture Bhagavata, and he is practicing it. And he is practicing Bhagavata principles, and you are following in his footsteps, so you are also automatically following the Shastric principles. So there is no contradiction there. There is a smooth alignment. So who is a bona fide spiritual master? Again, we will dive deeper into this in some other video where it needs a lot more attention. But again, scriptures give certain characteristics, certain criteria which a spiritual master should, fulfill. It's not like anybody calls guru this, guru that, no. This Baba, that Amma. And India is filled with such so-called gurus. They are cropping up like mushrooms. So the moment somebody says he is a guru, you have to test him. Is his life as per the scriptures? Is what he is saying as per the scriptures? Is he coming from a guru parampara, authorized guru parampara system, GPS? There are broadly four guru parampara systems. There is the Kumara Sampradaya, Sri Sampradaya, Rudra Sampradaya and Madhva Sampradaya. So my own spiritual master Srila Prabhupada is coming in the line of Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. So he is bona fide. So when a Sadguru comes, you should ask him, which Guru Parampara system are you tied to? Whatever he is speaking, not simply, of course, no doubt he is an eloquent speaker, he has interesting viewpoints and so many relevant topics, no doubt. But is he a bona fide Guru? How do you test? You should see that whatever he is seeing, is it as per the scriptures? Where is it in Bhagavad Gita? Where is it in Srimad Bhagavatam? Please give the reference. And there are four sampradayas. Which sampradaya are you tied to? It could be the great Sri Sri Ravi Shankar of Art of Living. Which guru parampara system is he coming from? So nothing against any gurus. Anybody. Even I can claim today, I am guru, all of you follow me. Any Tom, Dick and Harry can come and say that. But that does that mean that you start following? No, you should not. So we should not be very foolish in that. We should be very intelligent, because when you accept a guru, you are surrendering yourself and you are emulating everything that he is going to say. You are going to take his instructions. He is the Shrestha that you have to follow. Krishna is telling, Yad Yad Acharati Shrestha. So it's not a joke accepting a spiritual master. So that is what. If you want somebody who is physically present to serve, then find yourself a bona fide spiritual master. You find out from the scriptures what is the criteria, like a checklist. You find out, is this person fulfilling all this? Check, 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 check. Yes, then you are my spiritual master. Then I surrender to you. Then after that, whatever you say, I will follow. But before that, you have to be very intelligent. And along with that, you want some more role models, then find some sadhujana from great Vaishnava devotees who are trying to live their life as per the scriptures. So sadhu, shastra and guru, you follow these three, then you don't have to fall prey to all, you know, bogus gurus. So very important, we are still not done with this 21st shloka. I want to come back and share some more important things, especially on the path of bhakti. Who are the people that we need to emulate? Who are our role models that we can pick and choose from? So I'm going to talk about that in the next video. Until then, please contemplate on whatever I have shared today. Please share it with as many people as you can, so they can also get more knowledge on such important, relevant topics. So take care. We'll be back in the next video. See you soon. Hare Krishna.